You receive an order for heparin 40 units per kilogram per minute. The solution is labeled 500 units per mil. The patient weighs 12 kilograms. What is the correct rate in mils per hour? We'll solve this problem using proportions. We'll begin by determining how many units the patient needs per minute based upon their weight. So we know the requirement is 40 units per 1 kilogram. This must equal the rate of an unknown number of units, we'll call it x units, to the patient's weight of 12 kilograms. Before cross multiplying, notice how we have the same units on the top and the same units on the bottom. If we did not have this, we'd perform a conversion first. When cross multiplying, we'll leave off the units, so we'll have 1 times x, that's x, must equal 40 times 12, that'd be 480, which means the patient needs 480 units per minute. But because we're looking for the flow rate in milliliters per hour, we'll have to convert this to number of units per hour rather than units per minute. We can do this using another proportion. 480 units to 1 minute is equal to an unknown number of units, we'll call it y units, to 1 hour, but we need to have the same units on the bottom. Since 1 hour equals 60 minutes, we'll write this as 60 minutes. And now we can cross multiply. Once again, notice how we have the same units on the top and the same units on the bottom. So now we can cross multiply and solve for y. We have 1 times y, which is y, must equal 480 times 60, which is 28,800. Which means the order is really for 28,800 units per hour. Now that we know how many units the patient needs per hour, the last step is going to be to find how many milliliters the patient needs per hour, which will require one more proportion. The next proportion will compare the number of units to the number of milliliters. We begin with the known rate of 500 units per milliliter. So 500 units is to 1 milliliter as 28,800 units is to an unknown number of milliliters. We'll call it z milliliters. Again, this was units here. So once again, we have the same units on the top, same units on the bottom. So we can cross multiply and solve for z, which will give us the number of milliliters and therefore the rate in milliliters per hour. We have 500 times z, that's 500z, must equal 1 times 28,800, which of course is 28,800. Divide both sides by 500. We have z equals this quotient here. We'll go ahead and use the calculator. 28,800 divided by 500. Rounding to the nearest milliliter, notice how the 6 in the tenths place value means you round up, and therefore this would round to 58. So z is approximately equal to 58. And therefore the correct flow rate is 58 milliliters per hour. I hope you found this explanation helpful.